think we should, and I'm not a Ferrari guy, we should mark the Luca era as being just as important as the Enzo era. Luca di Montezemolo comes in and he saves Ferrari. He makes Ferrari from crappy cars, which regrettably they were at the end of the Enzo era, into good cars like yours. And he also made them very desirable. When he was, I'll say this, this is the term, kicked out unceremoniously by, oh, I forgot the guy's name, Sergio
Yeah, Fiat, yeah.
Marchionne. He had Ferrari running perfectly, and he said, we want to make as many Ferraris as people can buy and want to buy, minus one. So when he was kicked out, they made about 8,000 Ferraris. Last year, they made over 13,000. I think we're going to look back. It's too many. I think it's too many. And I think we're going to look back at the Luca era as a golden era, and he will be missed. And I think he probably already is. Your car is from that era.
Every single word you just said, I say amen. That's right. I mean, people look back at the Enzo era, like it, you know, it sort of glows and with some ethereal light because that's when the guy was there, and that's true. And it maybe is a little bit of the pressure we put on the air-cooled era Porsche, but to attach it to one man, and you're exactly right. I mean, you know, Ferrari is Ferrari, the man, but at the end of his reign, his cars were not terrific. Luca changed all that. He also brought Formula One glory back to Ferrari. Ferrari was languishing in racing, all the things that they stood for. So I don't disagree one.